two things that we'll try to make that are hard to understand in one way, but easy in another way, okay? He wanted to deny that there was a beginning point to the universe, and he used that equation by putting a number in there that made the universe to be static. He fudged,
yeah,
in
he
other
fiddled
words,
with the value of the cosmological constant.
That's right.
In order to get the two forces to exactly balance so he could portray the universe as static.
Okay.
And this again underscores the remark of Robert Dickey, that an infinitely old universe would relieve us of the necessity of explaining the origin of matter at any finite time in the past.
It also shows bias in science.
Well, sure. Einstein had a worldview, a point of view that at the time he was trying to preserve, and his own theory seemed to challenge the worldview, and so he fiddled with the equations. But to his great credit, he later came around. And there's a wonderful story.
He changed his mind.
He changed his mind.
But how did it happen? Because he was a stubborn guy.
Well, he was a very smart guy. But there was a Belgian Catholic priest physicist named Georges Lemaître.
Yeah.
And on a taxicab ride in 1927, going to a famous physics conference called the Solvang Conference, Lemaître put Einstein into the picture about the redshift evidence,
yep,
and explained what Hubble and Humason had discovered.
And Slipper too.
And right, and he also explained that Einstein's own equations most naturally implied a dynamic universe, that this fudging that he had done was very ad hoc from a physics standpoint,
right,
and the universe, even with the fudge, wasn't really static. Any slight perturbation in the orientation of matter would cause a collapse or an expansion. So, as a result of that conversation and a later one he had with Eddington, Einstein went out to Southern California and viewed the redshift evidence for himself with Hubble. And there's some famous newsreel footage where Einstein is peering through the telescope. And
Hubble's
says,
in the background with his pipe looking at it.
Yeah,
and
absolutely. It's, yeah. Yeah, it's a famous shot. So 2 weeks later, he gives an interview to the New York Times and tells the reporter that Hubble and his colleague Humason at Caltech have proven that the universe is not static, and later he admits that his attempt to circumvent the conclusion that the universe had a beginning by gerrymandering his own equations of general relativity was, quote, the greatest blunder of my life. And later he came to accept that the universe had a beginning.